On the Crime Watch tonight, the four-month search for Ryann Bunnell Crow is officially over. She was the young wife missing and presumed dead since her husband's arrest for murder in February. Well, tonight, the district attorney confirming that her remains have been found in the East Bay. Action News reporter Felix Cortez first broke this story. He has details on today's major development.
At a news conference Tuesday afternoon, District Attorney Dean Filippo announced that partial human remains found on Hayward's oceanfront in the East Bay 2 weeks ago are those of Ryann Bunnell Crow. In a statement written by her family, the confirmation was bittersweet.
The revelation that Ryann has been found is bittersweet for us. We're happy that she is found so we can bring her to rest in the proper way that she deserves, but this time also brings great sorrow.
Prosecutors believe Ryann Bunnell Crow was murdered by her husband, Jesse Crow, on January 30th. A short time later, her car was found abandoned in Foster City, which is just across the bay from where her remains were found. In the last 2.5 months, the search intensified in the East Bay based on several leads that came in. More than 100 law enforcement officers, divers, and volunteers searched the area. And then the discovery 2 weeks ago of several human bones. Early Tuesday afternoon, DNA testing confirmed they were those of the missing woman.
This is difficult in the sense that Ryan's family, like any family who has lost a loved one and not know the whereabouts, they have been in a great deal of pain and suffering. And this now brings at least a sense of closure that they now know where Ryann is.
Something that didn't come out at Tuesday's news conference is how Ryann Bunnell Crow died. District Attorney Dean Filippo says he has a pretty good idea, but he's not saying. That's something that should come out next month at her husband's preliminary hearing, scheduled for July 1st. Reporting from Salinas, I'm Felix Cortez, KSBW, Action News 8.
District Attorney Dean Filippo says his office will not make a decision on whether or not to seek the death penalty against Crow until after that July 1st hearing.